Hard to say the US isn't as racist and sexist as regressives say, with millions cheering I'll only hire X race and Y gender for Z job.
I don't think it's as bad as some claim that it is, but when one of the most powerful people in the country claims happenstances of birth, such as sex and race, are merits for hiring
for a particular job, and this person has done this repeatedly, and they say, okay, maybe you're right. That person is one President Joe Biden of the United States of America. He's open about it, and people cheer it. He said, I'm going to pick somebody to run with me who's a black woman, picked Kamala Harris. Said, I'm going to nominate somebody for SCOTUS to be an associate justice, good to be a black woman, everybody else is excluded. You know, he nominated Ketanji Brown Jackson. He's had some history in this.
Going back to 2003, which then, I'm already 30 years into his career, was again, I've been told that there's old white men who are in positions of power for decades as holding power. Maybe Biden's another one of these people. So maybe I'm the one who's wrong on the racist and the systemicness and the things of these things. But this was Joe Biden going onto CBS's Face the Nation to warn that if Bush nominated Janice Rogers Brown, she would face a filibuster. I can assure you that would be very, very difficult fight. She would probably be filibustered, Biden said. Asked by moderator John Roberts, wasn't she just confirmed? Biden replied that the Supreme Court is a totally different ballgame because a circuit judge is bound by state decisis. They don't get to make new law. Interestingly enough, if Brown Jackson is actually confirmed, there's a case coming up in the Supreme Court of the United States of America on if you can use race as one of the criteria to hire people. Let's get to the definition of racism. The first one from Merriam-Webster. A belief that race is a fundamental determinant of human traits and capacities, and that racial differences produce an inherent superiority of a particular race. That's what I normally I'm thinking about and meaning when I say racism or racist. Also, behavior or attitudes that reflect or foster this belief. Racial discrimination or prejudice. That's what I think. But I think most people, especially the regressives, what they mean is this 2A definition, the systemic oppression of a racial group to the social, economic, and political advantage of another. Now you see there, the advantage, that's the thing that counts. Now 2B, a political or social system founded on racism and designed to execute its principles. Now I find this problematic when you go in and you use the term that you're trying to define in the definition of the term. Like, that presupposes some accepted definition of racism already to define what racism is. And I think what most people are actually seeing and referring to as racist is something that is racial, and that's of relating to or based on race, or existing or occurring between races. When you have a country like the United States of America, it's the most racially diverse country that has existed in that size for this long with that kind of success. This is more about, if you don't vote for me, you ain't black, political blackness. Brown Jackson and Rogers Brown are both ADOS. Their parents are ADOS. This is American descendants of slaves, full on black, not to say like the Brown vice president who's part Asian, part Jamaican, was in the descendant of slaves, so she has that aspect in her background as well. So it's not necessarily just about the race. It's more about the politics that's in there. And I think in many of the cases in the United States of America and other places, when you actually look at this and you think, okay, this might be racist, you're actually talking about something that is racial. And one way to kind of pick that out is just think, is this something that is politically expedient for this person at this given time? Or are they consistent with calling X plus Y equals Z?